Right, hello, welcome along. I think this will be update number 4 for the Millennium BanDai Millennium Falcon. Not a great deal, I suppose it was a little bits and pieces to update this time. First of all, just I've been out today and bought some paints to start spraying this Falcon. I've gone for the Tamiya paints. I wanted an off-white as well, but I couldn't get it, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have to mix a bit of paint, some white, and then this sky grey, just to make that off-white, give that think. And then we got some different colours here, which I, according to the plan on the back, I've matched up. I've not done all of them, because obviously some of them are just bits you don't need. It's for the characters, etc., for the figures. But as I've got, I can do them a bit ad hoc, sort of thing. So I've got them, and also I've got a black paint, because I was using originally these they're not a very good picture, but these rail match paints. Bit of a nightmare to spray, go through the spray gun using the thinners, and I learned something this week. I thought, you know, this Tamiya thinner did all paints, but apparently, unbeknown to me, you need to really get the correct thinner for the paints. But there is a website, UMP, they do a universal thinner, so I might try and get that for at a later date. I got this information about the thinners, etc., from international scale model builders, scale models. Good bunch of lads. They tend to have a live show on a Friday night. Sometimes on a Tuesday night. It's hosted by Paul mainly. Wealth of information, so it's worth giving them a check out on YouTube. It's International Scale Modellers. They've also got a Facebook page, but it's a closed group, so you have to ask to go on if you can. But check them out on the YouTube first of all. See if they've always got plenty of time for people. So yes, that's the paints I've got. Other bits and pieces. I've got my spray booth set up here, but you can see it's not very well lit. I haven't got one that's got LEDs in it. I can move that over, just to make it a little bit brighter in there. But it's keep having to move things. So I had in my collection of stuff, I've always got bits and pieces around everywhere. I got this set of lights from IKEA. They're just a bunch of LEDs, but they're strips. They've got 4 strips, so I'm probably going to put some inside the spray booth, up on the top, 2 down the sides maybe, just to give a bit more light in there. You can be a bit groovy if you want to change all the colours. Let's have a look round. If you can see it or not, I don't know, but they've got them on there. You can see they're changing colour right now, but they're not too bad. It'll just give a bit of extra light. So, sorry about that dodgy camera movement. So yeah, so I'm going to put those up there. So where are we on the Falcon? Right, so I'd started spraying. And as I said, I was using the rail match paints for the black. And I was sort of, it's just me being a div, which it was in the end. Or there's something wrong. But let's get that better. I found that the paint was spluttering from my spray gun airbrush, and I thought it was just me, anything like that. But I found out since that it's actually the rail match paint and the thinners it's not done properly. So I started doing all the underside, trying to do all the seaming area. Let's see if I can get that there. If you can see or not. And yeah, it's not great. We've got all on the mandibles. I found out what they're called now. But yeah, so that's looking at it now. Actually, it's quite toned down now. It was a lot more pronounced on before. So I think what I might have to do. So that one's a bit more. I'll see how I go. But yeah, it's okay. I'm not happy, not entirely happy with it. But we'll see how we go from there. Now, I was a bit of a donut, and I've actually glued the gun section in, and I shouldn't have done that. And it is quite well glued because I used this Tamiya glue, the Tamiya extra thin, and it's a good weld. So I've glued that in by mistake, and also glued in this one as well. So double numpty. So I've got to be very careful now spraying the rest. I'm going to put try and detail a little bit in there, maybe just highlight some of the areas with some paint, some bits and pieces, get the seat and everything in there, get the glass in there, although I don't think about it, I think the glass has to go out from underneath, so I might have to pull that out, be very careful and do that. So I might have chuffed up a bit there, so we'll see. But it's the underside, so I'm not overly worried. We can do it properly on the top side. So yeah, that's why I'm at the moment. I've again used all the black and everything on here to spray inside the cockpit. Take that off there. So I've drilled out all the holes for the LEDs. Not for the LEDs, for the fibres, and then we get some paint and everything and start painting the inside, highlighting areas, get some colours in there, some white in there to where the strip light was on the sides, etc. Again, we'll do the same with this gun piece, gunning area, do that a bit better because obviously that's going to be the one on the top. And what else have I done? It's not very good. I might have to redo it, but it's sort of painted the seats. You probably can't see that. It's very bad. It's not very, very well. Let's see if I can zoom in on it under there and bring it there. So yes, I started painting the seats. I just used some old Humbro paint and a brush. I haven't sprayed these focus, so not brilliant, but plus I haven't done painting like this for a very long time, so it's just a matter of just focus, and maybe have to redo it again, maybe go back and look at the film, see if I got even the right color. Might need to do a bit of a tan color, not sure. So yeah, so that's where I am on that. I think my next step to do is, I haven't actually put any of the side pieces here, or the pipe work and everything on there. So I think I do need to do that now and get that done on there. Start getting it built up. Drilled all the holes. I need to drill another hole each side for the fibres. But yeah, so. Yeah, I think my next stage is to get all these side bits done on there properly. Right, so I haven't done too much tonight. What I have done, I have to zoom in on this one, I think. Let's have a look. If we can get there, bring that up. What I have done is I've put on all the pipework around the edges. That's a hole around the sides and on the mandibles. I've put these in. Oh, that one's falling out. I might have to put a bit of glue on that one. But Yeah, so it's all down there as well. And I put these in temporary at the moment, but I will have to pull them back out again for when I put in the fibre. But I'll leave them in there for when I do a bit of spraying. I haven't put the end pieces on, purely for the fact that I need to leave them off, because I think they're going to, when I do put them on, I think they're going to need to be glued in. So I'm going to wait for the fibres to go in those. Yeah, so all the pipe work is all done. Don't know if you can see there, just about see the holes drilled out, which I've showed before, for the fibres to go through there. So yeah, so that's not too bad on there. What else have I done? Oh yeah, I did get the gunnery bay out of there. I had to snap it off, but all I've done, I've just taken it off for now, and I've just painted some just little bits of silver in there just to give a bit of definition. I've done that on both of them. That's done as well. And then I've also painted the actual gunnery piece. It's just done black for now, and I will go in again with some colour for the seat, etc. I'm just going to let that dry. I'll probably leave that for now, but that's going to be it really. There's only a short update on this one. So very little done this time, but it's just getting there. They are really fiddly, especially if you're someone like me who's got fat thumbs. I did try and use some tweezers, but I just couldn't get on with those. But I must admit, the detail on this kit is absolutely amazing. It's tremendous, actually. So I'm really pleased with that so far. I should give it another wash. And then I should probably start by putting this together tomorrow. Or Friday, or next day, something like that. Yeah, next time. And then just start spraying over with the colour mix that I'm going to make. Like I said, I'm going to mix these two colours together, flat white with a bit of sky grey, to give that off-white colour. And we'll see how we go from there. But yeah, it's coming along. I'm at the point where I want to get it done now. It's been taking far too long, really. But then I haven't had a lot of time, so... I've got a whole weekend this weekend to do a lot. I'm going to start doing that. I'm also going to start on my Captain Phasma, BanDai Captain Phasma as well. So that's another project. And then after I've done this, I think I'm going to start on one of my Batmobiles. But I must admit, I'm impressed with this kit. But if I can get it done, finished this weekend, I'll be really pleased. But I can't see it. We'll see how things go. Anyway, that's it for now. Please like and subscribe, share, whatever. Been really good because I need some views and comments on my videos. I'll speak to you soon. See you soon. Bye-bye.